When the mechanistic worldview came in physics in the 17th century, there was an immediate attempt to extend it to life, to say that just as the universe is a giant machine, so living organisms are machines. But right from the beginning, this was controversial, because there were some people who said, wait a minute, you know, there are a lot of things about animals and plants and ourselves that don't seem to be like machines, even the fanciest machines you can imagine. What's happened is that physics and chemistry don't just have matter and energy now, they have fields. And fields are invisible organizing regions of influence, like the magnetic field around a magnet. Well, the exact nature of the morphic fields is hard to specify. You can describe them mathematically, and already mathematical models have been made of these fields. And what's new is the idea that these fields have a kind of inbuilt memory, and this means there's a kind of memory in nature. And I think it plays an extremely important role in the evolutionary process. I'm going to talk about the way that our minds are extended out, or at least our whole being is extended out as members of social groups. Most people have had telepathic experiences. It's common. It's often called paranormal, but it's not paranormal in the sense it's rare. It's actually very common. It's only paranormal in the sense it doesn't fit into the mechanistic theory of nature within science. It does fit into a wider view of science, as I've suggested, through morphic fields.
That's not supposed to happen.
Morphic resonance is a theory that tries to explain how the universe can have developing habits. Habits imply memory. And how would this memory work? Well, the suggestion is that it depends on similarity. The more similar something is to something that's happened before, the more it will be influenced by it. And morphic resonance is the process whereby similar things in the past influence similar things today.
I think morphic fields are what hold systems together. At every level, there's holes made up of parts that are themselves holes made up of parts. This is the holistic worldview. And this was what our ancestors believed until the 17th century, and it's what people around the world believe in one form or another.
The other thing that's becoming clear to a lot of people is that the whole debate is in biology is now being influenced by consciousness studies. That biologists are realizing, having left out consciousness for years, decades, centuries, it's becoming really important. And that is leading, I think, to a whole new perspective coming in, at least in relation to today. As soon as you start asking those questions and start looking at the details, it gets much more complicated. And simple answers don't work, and no one knows the answer, but the debate is opening up, and I think this is one of the most exciting areas of science at the moment.